Good morning. Day three. This is the state capitol, I think. This is the state capitol. It's the cutest little area. It's probably my favorite area. Stevie, is this the state capitol?
Yeah.
It's the state capitol. It's so pretty. Guys, we're at the Morse Farm of Maple Sugar Works. My gosh, look at how cute they are. They're little tiny. What?
Said they could fly the drone.
They did? The Woodshed Theater. This is so fun. I'm so glad we came here.
Would Debbie love this?
Yes. Spider web.
Here's the machine.
No way. Oh my heck, I wish my dad were here. Oh my gosh. Nelson Griggs was father of the modern sap collection system that is being used universally for maple production. Look at how cute like the flowers are. Oh my heck. I just can't get enough of it. I want to make maple syrup for the rest of my life.
A continuous stream when we're running the evaporator. The day that picture was taken, we took in 4,000 gallons of sap. We called that a good day's work. We went home, hit the hay.
So they have a little tasting area. And this is the lightest syrup to the darkest. And then this supposedly tastes like apple pie in a jar. And there's a bee that's attacking us. Can you freaking stand how cute this is, you guys? They all get progressively bigger. Look at that big daddy down there.
A few moments later.
You guys, we're at the Ben and Jerry factory. You guys, here we are. It's the best day ever. Don't you worry. I'm just getting too excited about ice cream.
Make sure you get a picture of Chunky Monkey.
Oh, see, I'm a half-baked girl.
Don't say it ever got you anything.
Guys, Bill just gave me a pressed penny from Ben and Jerry's. Steve, you excited?
I was excited as you, honey.
There's cows everywhere. You should love this. They feel a responsibility to give back to the community. That's what Ben's motto is. Did you see what Jerry's motto is? If it's not fun, why do it?
This is the door we're going into for the Ben and Jerry's tour. Excited?
Yeah.
They bought this old gas station and began creating their own flavors. But since poor Ben had no taste, we don't mean a sense of style, he really couldn't taste anything. They put in bigger and bigger chunks and swirls until he declared it ice cream perfection.
Part of our tour is going to be out on the mezzanine. Now that is the only place that we do not allow our guests to take pictures.
Oh, panic. Yummy.
In Tokyo.
Do they all allow tours?
None of them.
Just this one?
Yeah, this is the only factory you can take a tour of.
Oh, cool.
From 1986 to 1995, any new flavor that we created came to life first, right in this very moment. Unfortunately, the flavor you're going to try today is not very good, but it is good for you. Okay?
Oh.
Broccoli cheddar chunk is a broccoli ice cream. It has a spinach cheddar cheese swirl and dark red kidney beans.
Children, your tickets were free. You should all go to the back of the
wanted to know.
It's the best day ever.
Half-bakes number one. Is that fun, Steve?
Mm-hmm.
It's a perfect day.
Hey guys. So my brother that passed away, his and my favorite Ben and Jerry flavor is half baked. So I thought I'd take a picture with just me on one side and I'm gonna Photoshop his face in the other. Kind of fun. It's the best flavor out there. If you haven't tried it, you need to try it. And now I'm at the stop sign of Ben and Jerry. It has a little stop sign with the umbrella on top. It's just kind of cute.
A few moments later.
We are at the Joseph Smith Birthplace. It's really pretty. Kind of rainy. Well, it isn't super rainy, but. Steven's playing Floyd. It's really beautiful. And around this corner, there's a really big obelisk. Wow, you guys, it's really pretty. Can't get over it. They have like beautiful music playing everywhere in the woods. And I think the senior missionaries are a little concerned with Stephen's drone, but he's already landed it, so we should be good.
Then they went to Lebanon or something.
I've always wanted to take a selfie with Joseph.
Hello.
I really like these pictures.
He was like Grandpa Kim.
I really loved them, you know.
So the obelisk is a foot tall for every year of Joseph's life. So she said it was 38 feet. Is that right, Stevie?
I guess that sounds correct.
Born he was 38 nine, years old.
He was born in 1805 and died in 1844.
It's just so green and pretty. I love that it's overcast right now.
I did a big circle around the obelisk.
Oh, you did?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, cool. So this is the original cabin that he lived in.
Born in.
Wow, that's really cool. We can walk out to it. So you can go into this grove and they have music playing.
New Hampshire.
We're in Manchester, New Hampshire. And
and we're gonna see where my first place I ever lived in.
This is the first place that Stephen lived on his mission. In New Hampshire. Is that where we are?
Yep. Live free or die.
Live free or die. Really?
There was a bird nest that, like, all, it's not that fewer, there used to be a light up there.
Oh, yeah.
You can see what's left of it. There was a bird nest up there.
Nuh-uh.
And I thought the birds were out. I took a broom and started knocking out all these babies, started falling out. And I accidentally stepped on one and killed it.
Steve!
But there was one left that survived. I took it to Marina and she saved its life and sent it to a life. Yep.
Steve, that's so bad.
What?
That's such a terrible story.